See, in the last class about information storage and retrieval, we discussed about pre-coordinate indexing systems such as chain indexing, precise indexing, and POPC indexing. So, moving on with that, today we are going to index about discuss about keyword indexing. Okay, this is another form of indexing which uses keywords as the primary purpose for generating index term. So we will see what keyword indexing is all about with specific examples in this particular class. Okay. See, keyword indexing is a kind of indexing techniques which uses NLP, natural language, for indexing keywords or significant terms of a title. So here the definition itself clearly says that it uses natural language. That is a language which is commonly available based on the significant, that is important terms in the title, right? The important terms based on the title, they are generating the significant. Significant means important terms. Okay, so significant words are the words which have high correlation with the actual thought content of the document. Okay, in precis also I told you that in indexing the main idea is to surrogate. Surrogate is substitute. You have to represent the thought content, represent the subject content of the document through index term. So here significant words, that is important words, are recognized in such a way that they actually represent the thought content of the document. Okay, so keyword indexing, the concept of keyword indexing was given by Andrea Cristadoro. Okay, Andrea Cristadoro in 1864. Okay, in the name of keyword in title, KWIT. Okay, the acronym is KWIT. The concept of keyword indexing was given by Andrea Cristadoro in 1864. So I am telling this name and year because it will be useful for your NET examination. So remember it. Okay. So there was another term called catchword indexing, which was used to refer keyword indexing in the 19th century. So the same only, but another term, catchword. Instead of keyword, they used catchword in the 19th century. Okay. So British book in print used catchword indexing for quite a long time, and the well-recognized Nature Journal, you might have heard of it, that is a popular journal in science, uses this technique to derive keyword index entries for all their journal articles. See, most of the journals, most of the publishers are using keyword indexing techniques to provide index term for all their articles. See, in keyword indexing, the generation of keywords is done without the use of any vocabulary control device like thesaurus. That means they are not using any devices like thesaurus or dictionary or whatever it may be. Okay, or the word chosen may be a single word or multiple words, even phrases that convey the content. Okay, the word, the keyword, in the sense it may be a single word or more than one word, that is multiple word, or even phrases. Okay, that means even phrases that represent the thought content. That is very important. Okay, the significance of such keywords can be determined only by referring to the statement from which the keyword has been chosen. The statements acts as a modifier pointing up to the specific sense in which a keyword has been applied. So that means the keyword which is selected should be significant, and it should represent the subject content, that is thought content of the document. So several keywords may be selected for a title. So one title may contain more than one keywords. There are several keywords to provide access from different access point to user, right? So in a title like library administrator, for example, library administration, there is a title, means library is a keyword, administration is a keyword. That means we are providing more than one access point. We are providing two access points to the user. So there might be in a title, there might be more than one keyword to provide more access points. Okay, so there are eight known variants of keyword indexing. What are they? KWIC, KWOC, keyword in context, keyword out of context, keyword augmented context, and keyword KWWC, KTEL, PHA, VADX, DKWIC, and KLIC. So we will see all these things with specific examples in the forthcoming slide. So this is an overview about what keyword indexing is. So what you have to remember, keyword indexing uses significant terms based on natural language techniques, and mostly they collect from title to in order to represent the thought content of the subject. Okay, and they are not using any vocabulary devices like thesaurus. So there are three, the keyword, an entry of a keyword index has three parts. Okay, what are they? First one is keyword, subject denoting words or significant words which can be approach terms. So you are selecting based on a title or abstract or whatever in the text, you are selecting keywords, right? So that keywords is also called as significant terms or approach terms. Okay, that is the first part. Second is context, remaining part of the title serving as the context to the keyword. So there is a long title, so library administration, right? So library administration in the title, if you are selecting library as one keyword, administration as one keyword means, so first keyword, first approach term is library, and the next approach term administration becomes the context. Similarly, when you are selecting second approach term administration, and the remaining part of the title, what is it? Library, that becomes the context. Okay, so you will understand what is context with when I explain you with specific example. Okay, so then the third part is identification or location code. A number is provided, an ID number is provided in order to depict the location of the document where the document will be available. It is a location number, okay? It is an ID number to represent the location of the document, okay? So these are the three important terms of entry, three important elements of a entry in keyword index. So what is the indexing process? It consists of three distinct steps. The first step is we need to choose a keyword, right? The first step is we need to select keywords, that is approach terms or significant words. So either you see keyword, as I mentioned earlier, keyword can be either chosen from the title or abstract or even from the text, depending upon the nature, right? They have to represent the thought content of the document. Okay, you have to separate significant words. Significance mean important. Okay, what is the meaning of significant? Important words. Okay, so significant means important words. You have to select significant terms and non-significant terms, which are of no value. Okay, so what do you mean by non-significant terms? So non-significant terms like articles, like all the articles, a and the prepositions, conjunctions like and, pronouns, auxiliary verbs, and some general terms like viewpoint, reference. So these are non-significants. We need not to provide indexing for these, we need not to prepare index for these terms. So in other words, non-significant terms are called as stop list or stop words. Okay, see, the non-significant words are called as stop lists or stop words. Okay, significant words are the approach terms, non-significant words are the stop list. So let's take an example. See this example, treatment of skin diseases by using homeopathy. So that is the title we got. So here for this we have to prepare significant terms and non-significant terms. So significant terms in the sense it is approach terms, and non-significant terms is the stop list. So what are the keywords for this particular title? You can see treatment, skin disease and homeopathy are the significant terms. Based on this only user will try to search document, right? So and what are the remaining terms? By using, these are non-significant, so they are stop list. You need not to prepare index entries for stop list or stop words. Okay, so in this title there are four significant terms or four approach terms. Okay, so this is how you choose a keyword from a title. So what is the next part after choosing the significant terms? Entry generation. So index entries in KWIC or any of its versions, whatever it may be, are generated in association with all the words in batch of titles that are not stored in the top list. That means you have selected approach terms. In that previous example, we selected four terms, right? We selected four approach terms: treatment, skin, disease and homeopathy. So excluding all the stop list like off, by, using, we are going to batch the titles. We are going to generate keywords by associating them, by interlinking them. Okay, see, the title is manipulated so that keywords comes in the beginning or even in the middle, followed by the rest of the title. What do you mean by manipulated? What do you mean by manipulated? Manipulated means that is a slight alteration or changing. The title is manipulated. What is the title we saw? What is the title? You see, the title here is treatment of skin diseases by using homeopathy. This is the title. So now we are going to change, manipulate the title by using the keyword either in the front or even in the middle. Okay, see here, see the keyword is keyword comes front, right? And then the remaining part of the title comes. Okay, so that means we are changing, we are altering the title. So that part is called as manipulation. Okay, so the word is printed and displayed in context, that is together with the remainder of the title which it is appears. For example, here in the first sentence, treatment is the keyword and the remaining part of the title of skin disease by using homeopathy, that is the context. Okay, we saw three parts, right? Keywords, context, identification number. So remaining part of the title serving as context to the keyword. So when I see here, the treatment is the keyword. So whatever remaining after the keyword, remaining part of the title after the keyword is the context. So that is called keyword in context. Okay. So each significant word is normally written in bold face. That means it should be written in bold or in capital letter. Okay, here treatment is written in capital letter, right? It should be, because for identification, for emphasis. Okay, in this way, a single line entry. See, it is a single line only, right? It's a single line entry which includes title and source reference of some type is produced for significant keyword in the title. Okay. See, in the above example, there will be four index entries. We saw four terms: treatment, skin, disease, and homeopathy. Four significant terms. Significant or approach terms or keyword, that all are same only. Stop list means unnecessary, non-significant. Okay, remember that. Okay. So the last word and the first word of the title is separated by a symbol stroke. Please remember this. Either the last word or the first word of the title is separated by a stroke. That is a black slash. Okay. Or other symbols like asterisk or equal to or whatever it may be. And identification number is provided at the right end of each entry to link one entry with another. So this is the identification number. Okay, this is the identification number given to each document. Okay, you see here this stroke, what they are telling is the last word and the first word of the title is separated using a symbol called stroke or asterisk or equal to. Okay, here again I want to take you back to the title. Remember the title. Treatment is the first word of the title. Homeopathy is the last word of the title. Remember that. Treatment of skin diseases by using homeopathy. In this, four keywords are generated. Significant terms. Treatment, skin, disease and homeopathy are generated. Right. So, now the first keyword is treatment. So, what is the remaining part of the title? Of skin disease using homeopathy. See, since the first word itself is the keyword, significant terms, the remaining part of the title comes as it is. So there is no change in the title in this particular context. So there is no stroke sign here. Okay, can you understand? So second part is skin here. So this is the title. Treatment of skin disease by using homeopathy is the actual title. Since treatment itself is a keyword, here we don't need not to change the title, manipulate the title, because treatment itself is a keyword. It comes in the first itself. So no need to change it. So see, next second keyword is skin. So skin is the second significant word. So now the second approach term should come in front because it is a keyword, right? See here, according to this rule, the keyword comes in the beginning or even in the middle. That's okay. So skin should come front in the second keyword. So what is the remaining title? Disease by using homeopathy is the remaining title ends there. So now we have to give a stroke there and then see treatment of will come. So treatment of skin disease by using homeopathy is the actual title. So since we are using skin as the approach term, so whatever whatever term in sentence that comes after the keyword skin will be the context of the, it will be the context of the approach term, and after the title ends and the beginning of the title, you need to give a stroke. So homeopathy is where the title ends, treatment of where the title begins. Okay, see, homeopathy ends, treatment begins. So here you need to give an approach term. So similarly, what is the next keyword? Disease. Where disease comes? Disease by using homeopathy. Here disease is capitalized. By using homeopathy, homeopathy is the end term of the title. You are giving a stroke, and the remaining part of the title is written. Treatment of skin. Okay. This is how context is preserved. This is how context is preserved. And the final keyword is homeopathy. That is the last part, end. So then you have to give a stroke, and then the beginning part of the title is written. So here the keyword is emphasized along with the context of the keyword is preserved. Okay. So this is keyword in context. So this is the second part. So after generating the entry, first you have to choose keyword, and then you have to generate entry by preserving the context, and then you have to file the entry, right? Filing of entries. So how will you file the entries? We have generated it. So all the entries are arranged alphabetically. Okay. All according to their keywords, right? So here you see treatment skin diseases. So our alphabetical means D will come first. Okay. D will come first. Homeopathy will come second. Skin will come third. And treatment will come fourth. See, it is arranged alphabetically. We didn't change anything. We have just file the entries in alphabetical order. So you see this in the above example, the first words disease, the first, what is the first word? These are the first words. Disease, homeopathy, skin, and treatment are the keywords. Remember it. The part of the title followed by each keyword is the context. What is the context here? See, this is the part of the title followed by the keyword disease. So this is the context of disease. See, this is the part of the title followed by the keyword homeopathy. So this is the context of homeopathy. That means the part of the title, whatever remaining part which is available after the, which is followed after the keyword, that part is called context. So the last number, the number attached on every entry to the extreme right, is called the identification code. So these are the different elements of entries in keyword indexing. So this is the overall process of keyword indexing, right? So this is how the indexing process goes. So we will see the variants of keyword indexing. The first one is KWIC, keyword in context. So KWIC was developed by H.P. Lund in the year 1958. Okay, I'm giving this year because for your NET examination purpose, okay? For your NET examination purpose, I'm giving this names and years, okay? So just make a note of this. See, here, whatever we saw the example in the indexing process, that is related to keyword in context only. Okay? So, it is developed by H.P. Lund. H.P. Lund in the year 1958. Here you see this mechanized system is based on the title of the documents. This mechanized system is based on the title of documents indexed on the principle that title of a scientific document represents its content. See, the main aim of keyword indexing is to represent the thought content of the document. Okay, they feel that the subject is represented, the thought content of the subject is represented by the index terms, that is the keyword or the approach terms. Okay. So the index is produced by rotating each significant term at the title in the title at the beginning. We saw the indexing process, right? everyone is rotate, everything is rotated like this. See, the title is changed by rotating it. So here disease comes first, then homeopathy comes first. That means this is a rotation process, manipulation process. Okay, my keyword is placed at the beginning. Okay, the remaining part of the title with each significant term is a context, we already discussed, right? So that is called keyword in context. Okay, so keyword in context may be carried out on various level, depends upon the purpose that index is to serve. Okay, so don't restrain that keyword is carried out only in title. It may be carried out in abstract or even from the text of the document also. So based on the purpose, keyword are generated, right? Kivik is generated. So keywords can be defined, and I am not going into, because I have already explained this part. Okay, keywords are significant terms which represent the thought content of the document. Which doesn't represent the thought content of the document are called as non-significant terms, otherwise stop words. Okay, terms like report, analysis, theory, propositions, articles, of, and the, whatever it may be, all common words fall into stop words, non-significant or common words. Okay, so this is the, what do you say, this is the concept of KWIC. I have explained this with an example also. So let us see an example, one more example for better understanding. Okay, so take this example, preservation of disease of wheat caused by index. Okay, so already I have told you about the function of stroke, right? So in order to preserve the context, after the last word and the first word, there will be a stroke for stroke in order to separate it, okay, in order to identify it. So here, what are the keywords? Here, what are the keywords in this particular title? Prevention is a keyword, disease is a keyword, wheat is a keyword, insect is a keyword, right? So what are the stop words of caused by? So these are the stop words. Okay, that means you can exclude it, you can remove it. See, here the first is disease. So diseases of wheat. So diseases. So here after diseases, what is the title? Of wheat caused by insect. So insects is the last word. So after that, you need to give a stroke and then remaining part of the title. That is the starting part, prevention of. Similarly, here next keyword is insect. So insects come, they have given in alphabetical order. Okay, they have already filed the entries in alphabetical order. Okay, so insects. So insects is the last word. So after the last word, you need to give a stroke. And then prevention of diseases of wheat caused by. That is the context. Okay. Similarly, for other keyword, after the last word, you give a. Here you see prevention. This is the title itself. Prevention of diseases of wheat caused by insects. The actual title itself comes there. So after the last word, you just give a slash. Simple. Because there is no context. The title itself is preserved. So this is the context here. Of disease, wheat caused by insect. After whatever comes after the keyword is the context. Okay. So after the stroke mark here, there is no remaining part of the title, because the actual title itself is represented here. So wheat comes here, wheat caused by insects. So after insects, you give a stroke and then prevention of. So sometimes in the first part, I have told you that in the index, you remember this, I have told you that the keyword comes in the beginning or even in the middle also. Okay, not only in the beginning, it can come in the middle also. That's why I gave you this example, see. It can come in the middle like this also. Okay, and I told you it can be either made capitalized like this, or you can make it bold. Okay, these are the two ways to emphasize the keywords. So in the middle, if it comes in the middle in computer generated index, keywords can be positioned at center also like this. So prevention of disease. So disease is the keywords. So disease is emphasized with the capital letter and bolded. Of wheat caused by insects. And then after the last term, they give a stroke mark. And then the second one is insects. So insects come as the end part, right? So diseases of wheat caused by comes below. Okay. And then insects, after insects, they gave a stroke mark. So because that is the last word. So wheat caused by insects, again, after insects, they gave a stroke mark and prevention of disease of. Okay. So similarly, it can come in the end also. So I will show you another example for better understanding. The same KWIC with another example. Let's take another example. I think you will understand with this example a little bit better. Classroom behavior of urban students in India. So that is our title, and they have given an identification code of 46135. So here the what are the keywords? First you have to determine the keywords and the stop words. Here the keywords is classroom behavior, India, urban students. See, there are five keywords here, and what are the stop words? Off and in are the stop words. That means they are non-significant. They need not to be added in the index terms. Okay. So behavior. So first they have automatically arranged in alphabetical order. Okay. So yeah, they have filed entries in alphabetical order. So behavior comes first. After behavior of urban students in India, and after India there should be a stroke and then the remaining part of the title. So similarly for every other keywords they have done like this. So this is where the keyword appears at the beginning. So similarly, when the keyword appears in the center, it will look like this. Okay, classroom behavior of urban students in India, and then for classroom in India slash, and then classroom behavior of urban students. See, for India in the keywords, students in India bar slash stroke classroom behavior of urban. Similarly for students as a keyword, of urban students in India slash classroom behavior. This is how it will look when it comes in the middle part of the title. When the keyword, it can be either in the beginning or even in the center. Okay, so this stroke is very important after the end or the beginning of the title. Okay, so this is all about KWIC, keyword in context. Now we are going to see another variant, which is KWOC, keyword out of context. So what do you mean by out of context? So that means it is not in the context, simple. So KWOC is another version of keyword indexing, in which each index is taken out and printed separately. Okay, it's, that means it is keyword is taken out and printed separately. Here it is not like that. Keyword is with the context only. So whatever remaining after the keyword, that is the context in Kivik, right? Here it is not like that. So whatever, we are just taking the keyword and we are printing it separately. That is out of context. On the left hand margin, with complete title to provide complete context. The identification number is written on the right as usual. Okay. So we will see this with an example for a better understanding. See the same example, prevention of diseases of wheat caused by chemicals. So based on KWOC, KWOC, the indexing will be like this. Diseases, chemicals, prevention, wheat. So it looks the same only now. So what is the difference? See, here after the keyword, the complete title is given. You see, for every keyword, the complete title is given, with the complete title to provide complete context. Here, the context is not preserved based on what comes after the keyword. Here, the complete title is given. That is, keyword is taken out of the context and placed it separately. Here they have taken the disease in this first sentence. Here disease is the keyword. They have taken disease out of the title and kept it. They have taken disease out of the context. Here the context is the full title. Out of the context and kept it separately. So that means they are giving all the terms of the title than keeping the keyword separately. That is out of the context. Okay. In Kivik it is not like that. Kivik is not like that. Keyword is there within the context only. Keyword is within the context. Here, see, after behavior, see the title. What comes after behavior? Of urban students. It comes like this. But whereas in KWOC, it is not like this. They have just taken diseases separately and placed the full title. That means keyword is separated from the actual title and placed. So when you are taking out, that is called out of context. Okay, the context is preserved by, the complete context is preserved by presenting the full title. I hope you understand this. So this is one way of generating keywords using KWOC, and another way is like this. That means keyword is printed as a heading and title is printed in the next line instead of same line, like this. Instead of same line, they will give an enter and they will print the title in the next line. Okay, here you see, this gives a clear clarity, right? So disease is taken out of the context of the title and then it is emphasized. So that in keyword in context is not like that. Okay. In keyword in context, so if disease comes means of wheat caused by chemicals, a stroke will come, then prevention will come. Here it is not like this now. So here the full title is shown in the context. Keyword is taken out. Remember that. So that is why it is called as keyword out of context. So in KWOC, an asterisk appears in the printed title in the position of and instead of the keyword featuring as a heading. See, instead of the keyword in the after what you say in the computer generated index, what happens is after generating all these keywords, so here for example in this particular part, disease is the keywords. So instead of printing diseases like this, what the computer will do, it will provide an asterisk symbol, prevention of asterisk of wheat caused by chemicals. Here prevention of diseases of wheat caused by asterisk symbol will be there. Wherever the keyword comes, the asterisk symbol will be there. So that is an example like this. A description of, for example, adults, a description of study of Indian adults in North Indian region. So here adults is the keyword, right? So instead of writing adults here, they will the computer will print an asterisk. That means that adult words, that adult is present in this part of the title. So like this, in computer will generate it like this. Here chemical is presented here. So instead of writing chemicals, they will provide an asterisk. So that is an example, simple. Here you see, read the title. What will be the title? The advanced evolution of globular cluster stars. So here advanced is the keyword, right? So instead of writing advanced, say asterisk symbol is generated. So see, the KWOC format preserves the title verbatim. That means it preserves the full title, but it fails to provide the convenient adjacent context with which the keyword format is provided. That means adjacent means near. So in keyword in context, whatever context comes after the keyword, that is the adjacent next part, right? But here in KWOC, it is not like that. It provides the full title as the context. So the next part, whatever comes as the adjacent context, is not preserved. So that is the primary difference between KWIC and KWOC. Hope you understand this. So the next one is KWAC, keyword augmented in context. So I hope you understand what is KWIC and what is KWOC. So now we are moving on to KWAC, keyword augmented in context. So what do you mean by that? It is also called as keyword and context. Okay, either augmented in context or keyword and context, both are same only. It is the improved version of KWIC. It is what, an extended version, right? In many cases, title alone cannot represent the thought content of the document. Okay, that is true actually. Based on the title, you cannot say what is actually written in the book or what is actually written in the article, right? So for that purpose, for the shortcomings of KWIC, they have formed KWAC. So the keyword of a fancy title can be a problem in the retrieval of relevant documents, right? In order to solve the problem of retrieving irrelevant documents, KWAC provides additional keywords, okay, taken either from the abstract or from the original text. So what it does is instead of restricting it to the title, it goes into the abstract and the text to get the actual thought content of the document. So KWIC, they follow mostly on title, right? So only title alone cannot represent the thought content of the document. So what they do, they will read the abstract and some titles may be confusing, right? So they will read the abstract and they will read the full text to identify what the document is talking about. So here the meaning of augmented here, in addition to. What is the meaning of augmented? In addition to. That means you are adding additional words, extra words that representing the subject. So we will see what is KWAC with specific example, right? So let's take this particular example. African women in agricultural development. So here, based on this title, what we understand, they are talking everything about, they are talking wholly about women in Africa. But when you read the concept, here the concept African women is not, in reality, does not include all the women. See, when you read the article, you understand that it does not include all the women in Africa, but only the women of Sierra Leone. Okay, Sierra Leone is a place in Africa. So they have given title as African women, but only they are talking about one particular place or one particular city. So unless you read the document, you will not get it. So based on this title, if you index this means, it will become wrong, right? Based on this title, if you index this means, Sierra Leone will not appear in the index term. So people searching for this document will find it difficult to retrieve. So after reading the abstract and what you say, the text of the documents, we found out that they are not talking wholly about African women. They are talking only the women in the one part of Africa, that is Sierra Leone. The main focus of the study is to employment condition of women in agriculture. You see, what is the main aim of the study? Employment condition of women, that is African women in agriculture development. They have given like this. When you study the objective, you identify that employment condition. What is the condition of employment? So that is one they want to identify. See, and after a detailed study, again, it came to light that working hours is the central theme of document. Okay, so see, after reading, they have identified additional words. So these addition to are called augmented. Okay, augmented words. Okay. So after reading the document only, you can justify this. Oh, this is talking about not full African women, only the women in Sierra Leone. And the focus is employment condition of women in agriculture. That too with the central theme of working hours. See, after reading this document, we have identified three additional keywords. That is three augmented words. Okay. So what are they? Sierra Leone, employment condition, working hours. So based on this, you are generating the keywords in order to represent the thought content of the document. Okay. It is an extender. It follows same as Kivik, but it also includes additional terms. In Kivik, we follow only whatever terms in the title. Okay. Here it is not like that. And if you follow only the title, what will be the keyword? African will be the keyword. Women will be the keyword. Agriculture will be the keyword, right? So here, see, they have added extra words, that is augmented words, by reading the document, employment condition. So it gives, what you say, better information retrieval. Okay. So similarly, you take another example, the use of peer tutoring and programmed radio instruction cannot be understandable. So the title is the use of peer tutoring and programmed radio instruction. That is the title. It cannot be understandable unless the term peer tutoring is explicitly indexed. Okay. So terms like educational radio, that means they are giving instruction through radio, right? That is the actual, they are giving instruction through radio. So tutoring means they are giving educational instructions. So they are adding educational radio, programmed instruction, non-formal instructions are added. So these words are augmented. Okay. Are added to augment the actual concept of the document. I hope you understand what is keyword augmented in context. Okay. So both KWIC and KWOC takes from the title, whereas KWAC adds additional words to augment the context in order to preserve the thought content of the context in a better way. So one more example for better identification, classroom behavior of urban students in India. So when you take this classroom behavior, see what are the extra keywords after reading. So classroom behavior means students should be disciplined, right? So discipline is mentioned here. And classroom behavior of urban students in India. So urban students in India means it is a metro city, right? Metro city, urban is a city. Okay. So here the term behavior means discipline. That is true. And the study was conducted for boarding school. So this study was conducted only for boarding school students. Okay, boarding school students, that is that too in the urban cities. Okay, boarding school means hostel students, students who are staying in the hostel, that is called as hosteliers. So hosteliers are added. So boarding school is added. Urban refers to metro cities. Okay, so see, the four additional words are added to augment the context of the document, right? Similarly, for another title, Monetary Policy of India. Here, monetary policy, who takes care of monetary policy in India? RBI only. So Reserve Bank is the main concern of the document, right? So they are adding RBI. So Monetary Policy of India is a recession policy, and interest rate are the concerned area of the document. Here, when you read the document, you understand that interest rate and recession rate are the main part, main focus of the document. So, after reading the document, they get an understanding that this is the main focus. They need to be added in the, they need to be added as additional keywords. So, that's why they are augmenting and enriching the thought content of the document by adding these extra terms. So, this is what KWAC, augmented in context, is all about. So far, we have studied the three important variants of keyword indexing: KWIC, in context, out of context, augmented context, right? So now we are going to see keyword with context. Okay, what do you mean by with context? So the keyword with context in another version of KWIC. So you see, KWIC is the base for everything. So where one part of the title, where only one part of the title, instead of full title, only they take only one part of the title relevant to the keyword, and it is considered as the entry term. So sometimes for clarity and delimitation of the scope of the subject, a secondary aspect of the scope of the subject is added into the primary aspect. So in order to ensure clarity and for delimiting the scope of the subject, we are adding one more secondary term to the primary term. Okay, so let's see this with a specific example. So one more thing, Indian Science Abstracts ISA is using KWC for its indexing. So remember this, will be sometimes these kind of questions will be in the NET examination. So remember this, Indian Science Abstracts uses, so which kind of agency uses KWIC, which kind of agency uses KWOC, they might ask. So remember this, that's why I have given this also. Indian Science Abstract uses KWWC. Okay, remember that. So let's see an example. Okay, this is the title: Bacterial Contamination in Indian Distillers Using Waste Molasses. So this is the title. So we are going to index using KWWC method. So bacterial contamination. So here they have added a secondary. There they have added a secondary aspect called alcohol fermentation. So alcohol fermentation, when you use this, so what do you say? When you use this, that is the effect. Alcohol fermentation is the effect of bacterial contamination. Okay. Alcohol for bacteria, what happens is bacterial contamination, alcohol fermentation becomes the effect of bacteria. Bacteria is contaminated in the Indian distillers. Okay. So in distillers, bacteria is contaminated. So when you use alcohol fermentation, bacteria dies. So they have added a secondary term. For a clarity. You remember this part. For clarity and delimitation of scope, they are adding secondary term with the primary term. So bacterial contamination is a primary term which is preserved in the title. So alcohol fermentation is a secondary term which is used for better clarity. So bacterial contamination, effect of alcohol fermentation. So what happens when you have alcohol fermentation, bacterial contamination will happen. So fermentation, alcoholic, effect of bacterial contamination. Molasses, alcohol fermentation, effect of bacterial. So this is how they are preserving the keyword. Keyword with context. Okay, they are not taking out, they are just keeping the keyword with the context. Okay, so they are adding one more term. Okay, what is it? Alcohol fermentation is a term added. So that is a secondary aspect. So all other they have kept it. So they have removed what you call Indian distillers and everything, and molasses is there. So molasses is a keyword here. Bacterial contamination is a keyword. So that means I have told you that in certain places, keyword not only a term, it might have phrases also, it might have a sentence also. So here you see a whole sentence is a keyword, right? The whole phrase, effect of bacterial contamination, is a keyword. Here alcohol fermentation is a keyword. That means multiple keywords. Okay. So they have segmented in such a way. So we will see another example: Implausibility of distillation theory in radio frequency breakdown in isometric liquid. That is the title. So this is the identification number 667. So here they have taken distillation theory. Here distillation theory is a keyword, isometric fluid is a keyword, radio frequency breakdown is a keyword. They have taken three significant words and others are stop words. So what do you say? They have just placed implausibility in radio frequency breakdown in isometric liquid. That means they have removed this distillation part, okay? They have removed this distillation theory part because that is the keyword. This is not KWOC. In KWOC, they will present the actual title in the context, but only the part of the title relevant to the keyword is presented. Here, bacterial contamination is the keyword. Only the part of the title which is relevant to the keyword. So, bacterial contamination is relevant to effect of alcohol fermentation. So, only that part is preserved. So, similarly, distillation theory is the keyword. So, only the part which is essential for that keyword is preserved, not the whole document. When you are preserving the whole title, it is called as KWOC. When you are preserving only the part, that is called as KWWC with context. I hope you understand the difference. It only the part, you see, there is not full title, only the part here, only the part is there. So you are taking a keyword, only the part which is associated with that keyword is preserved. So you are taking the keyword molasses. So molasses is a part of alcohol fermentation and effect of bacterial contamination. So only that part is preserved, not the whole title. Similarly, distillation theory is, instead of preserving everything, they have preserved only that part. So here they have removed isometric liquid, right? So isometric liquid they have removed. And our radio frequency breakdown, they have removed it. Only the part which is associated with the keyword is preserved. So that is called as keyword with context. If you are preserving the full title, it is KWOC. Remember that, okay? So now we are going to learn one more concept. Key term alphabetical, okay? Key alpha, that is the term, that means key term alphabetical. So it is a permuted subject index that lists only assigned keywords assigned to each abstract, okay? So it is an index, subject index that assigns keyword to each abstracts, okay? In key t alpha, only keywords are taken from the title instead of the full title. They are taking keywords from the title instead of full title. They are taking only from the title. You see, this is an example. Are arranged side by side without forming a sentence. Here in all the four methods we saw, it is like a sentence, right? So here it will not be in a sentence. Okay, they are just arranged side by side with the punctuation mark comma separating each and every keyword. So the entry generation of our document, example. Acquisition of journals in a university library in Japan will be like this. What are the keywords? Acquisition is a keyword, journal is a keyword, Japan is a keyword, university is a keyword, library is a keyword. Okay, so these are the keywords, right? Instead of preserving the context or everything, they will form only the keywords and they will place in sequence order by separating. They will not place in the form of sentence. Instead, they will just separate every keyword using a comma. Simple. Okay. You see, they are given in alphabetical order, but all the keywords should be filed in alphabetical order. Remember that. So here, when you take the first order, acquisition, journals, university, library, Japan, it should come like this, but they have changed it because they have to present it in alphabetical order first. And then you see the second one is journals. So when the journals takes over the first as approach term, so the acquisition goes last. Similarly, Japan comes first and journals goes last. Library comes first and then Japan goes last. See, so this is the order they have filed, right? So only instead of preserving the context, every part of the title, we have taken only the keyword and they have arranged the keyword in a sequence, not in a sentence. Okay, not in a sentence, they have separated each keyword by a comma, okay? Similarly, for the title preservation of diseases of wheat caused by insect, the same title, see, the keyword will be like this. Only prevention, disease, wheat, insects are the four keywords, right? So they have given with separated by comma. Only the first approach, first keyword, that is approach term, that is emphasized or capitalized or bold, okay? So again, the order will follow for all the four keywords. It is actually easy to understand, okay? There is no sentence here. Only all the keywords are taken. They are placed in one sequence and they are separated by a comma. And the sequence follow. And I just want you to give an overview about what is VADX, okay? VADX stands for Word and Author Index. Okay. Word and Author Index. Okay. It stands for Word and Author Index. It is an improved version of KWIC where the names of the author are also treated as keyword along with significant subject terms and facilitate to satisfy author approach also. So far we saw only the title and abstract or the thought content of the document are taken, right? Now WADX what it does is it takes the names of author also. It takes the names of author also. That is why it is called as Word and Author Index. So that is the difference between normal keyword indexing. It is also a keyword index, but it includes author names also. Okay, it can be used for both retrospective and current search. Alphabetical sequence, the entries are printed out in context. Words are hyphenated words, pair of tagged words. It's arranged in two columns. Both the columns are printed simultaneously with dictionary entries at the top, pagination at the bottom by the computer. Okay. So see, we will see this with an example for better understanding. So remember, it is used in Applied Mechanics Review. So Applied Mechanics Review is a publisher, a journal publisher. It is a journal. They are using WADX system for generating their entries. Remember this. AKWIC, author and keyword, is another version of WADX. So the difference between all the keywords and WADX is WADX includes authors also, author names also. So see an example. Selected water resource index for Wisconsin. Okay. Wisconsin. So this is a title. Selected water resource index for Wisconsin. That is a title. Okay. So there are various terms added. Like here the author name is not there. Everything they will add it. Okay. So here Wisconsin University can be indexed to various terms like Wisconsin University is added. Madison Water Resource, they are just reading the thought content also of the document also, and they are adding author terms and another key terms. Madison Water Resource Center, water resources, water rights, water supplies, water treatment. Here, Wisconsin University and Madison Water Resource Center is the corporate author of the title and water title. Okay. And water resources and water rights are the significant terms of the title. Okay. See here. Wisconsin University and Madison Water Resources are the corporate author of this document, and water resources, water rights are the significant, that means key terms. So index entry will consist of like this. So Wisconsin University, water resources for Wisconsin, again with the identification number. So again for corporate, another corporate author, Madison Water Resource Center, water resources for Wisconsin. Okay. See. And they have removed selected is non-significant, right? So they have removed. So like this, they will generate keywords for all the entries for both words as well as author. Okay, so here all the five are for this particular title. They have added Wisconsin University, Madison Water Resource Center, water resources, water rights, water supplies, water treatment. So they have added 6 significant terms. Out of the 6, Wisconsin University and Madison Water Resources are the corporate author of this title. Okay, and other four are the significant terms. So after including all the significant terms, so this is how the index will look like in WADX format. Okay. So what is DWIC? DWIC is double KVIC. We know what is KVIC, right? Keyword in context. When you double KWIC, it becomes DKWIC. Okay. Again, it is another improved version. So the keyword is extracted from the title, and regarded as the main index term. That is true. Okay. The remaining words are rotated using a wrap around format. So in KWIC, what we will do is we will select 4 keywords, and whatever title comes after the keyword are kept in context, right? So here it is rotated using a wrapped around. Let's see that. In DKWIC, specific search for 2 words in combination is possible. So that means it is doubling. They are doing a specific search for 2 words. They have most of the features, facilities of and failures of KWIC and KWOC index. So let's see an example so that you will understand. The computer analysis of weather forecast. See, the computer analysis of weather forecast, here the first keyword is computer, right? See, here the first keyword is computer. So they have taken computer out of the context and kept it separate as a heading. See, so in keyword KWIC, what comes after computer? Analysis of weather forecast, right? Analysis of weather forecast is written here, and they are hyphenated, okay, wrapped around. See, they are hyphenated, and then the is there. Instead of using the keyword computer, they have given asterisk mark, right? In KWOC, they use asterisk mark. We studied that. So similarly, and then forecast. So the context is changed. Forecast, the analysis of weather, and then weather forecast, the analysis. This is how the title is wrapped around and rotated and manipulated for each keyword, right? In KWIC, we won't do like this. We will only preserve what is after the keyword. But here, for a single keyword, they are preserving every possible ways of the title, right? Similarly, for analysis, the computer asterisk of weather forecast, like this it will come. So the stop word. They need not to take it, but they have taken this because they need to separate the significant terms from the non-significant terms, okay? They have separated it. In KWIC, how they will separate the last and the first term? Using a stroke, right? Here they didn't use a stroke. Instead, they used a hyphen. So, the is the first part of the title and forecast is the last part. In KWIC, we use a stroke like this. But here they have used hyphen. Remember that. Simple. So, that's why computer analysis of weather forecast, instead of stroke, hyphen and then the. Again, weather forecast, hyphen, because that is the end of the title, the computer off. Again, forecast, hyphen, the computer off. See, all possibilities of a single keyword can be done. So, they are doubling the entries of QIC as well as KWOC. So, that's why it is called as double KWIC index. So what are the advantages? Some of the advantages are, it is speed. The main merit of keyword indexing is the speed and economy which index can be produced owing to its machine origin. Okay, because all the entries are generated by computer, right? It can generate it very fast. Okay, so absence of interpretation of content leads to prefer consistency and predictability, right? If a word appears in the title of the document, it is certain unless the word in the stop word is, entry will be generated on the word. Okay. So, if the word comes in the title, it automatically generates keyword. Most of the keywords are generated from the title, right? So, automatically it generates keyword from the title. So, consistency is maintained and predictability is also there. That means keyword index predicts from the title only. In knowledge-based economy, human intellect has become costlier day by day and difficult to find. It does not require intellectual effort or trained indexing staff as it produced by the computer. See, in order to read each and every document to understand the thought content of the document, it is very difficult. So when you take keywords from the title and the computer, when you program in such a way in the computer that the computer takes keyword from the title, right? So automatically everything is done. So human intellect has become costlier. That's true. It is difficult to find experienced professionals and experts, right? So for this technique, you need not to have some experts. Only they are taking from the title, right? And arranging it in some order. Most of the users search by title rather than author. So keyword index is very useful for that purpose. That is true. So most people, if I want the colon classification, I will search only by title, right? Not by author. So that means its keyword index is very useful, very very useful, because it takes index from the title. KWIC, keyword in context, permit the cross correlation of subjects to an extent, but not realizable by conventional procedure, right? It permits cross correlation because it preserves the context after that comes after the keyword. So cross correlation, a relation between subjects is possible. KWIC does that. Nowadays, authors, especially in the fields of science and technology, use representative and meaningful titles which express the contents of the document. So keyword indexing leads to better results. That is true actually. Nowadays, authors who are writing documents, articles or whatever it may be in the science, in the field of science and technology, they use clear title to represent the thought content of the document. So if the title is clear and the title represents the thought content, the keyword indexing is very easy and keyword indexing is very useful. it satisfies the current approaches. What is the current approach of the user? They search by, they search most of the document by title. That is the current approach. No need for vocabulary control. Oh, here you no need not to have any vocabulary control. In PopC, there is a vocabulary control device called Clasarus to identify the terms, right? Here it is not like that. Within the title, you can just handle the indexing procedure. And there are some, what do you say, disadvantages also. What are they? It is good for science and technology, but not effective in humanities and social sciences. That is true. Where no controlled vocabulary is used. It depends on the title of the document. If the title is not representative, it will become ineffective. For example, if you see, there is a title like Black Money, White Power. What do you mean by that? Black Money, White Power. Okay. Based on this title alone, we cannot identify what the document is talking about, right? So, our integration for and against, this is the title. You are getting a title like this, means how will you index it using keyword indexing? So, unless you read the document and augment the thought content, it will be difficult, right? So, there is some of the disadvantages. It's normally produced by computer on the format of fixed field length. Due to this fixed field length, part of the title is truncated when the title is lengthy. This truncation leads to funny results far away from the context. That is true actually. So Kivik, KWIC, what do you call it? It is generated by computer. That means there is a fixed length of characters. That means for a keyword, for example, I am saying there is 15 characters only. If the title is long, if one keyword is having 16 characters and one word will be missing. If one word is missing, means it entirely changes the context, right? And it will produce some funny results. That is what he is talking about. Scattering of illiterate term occurs because alphabetical arrangement. Search of a topic may have to be done under several keywords. It takes very high search time. Several pages of entries under one information for some documents rapidly rejected. Arrangement of entry terms can break down long sequences, right? See, scattering means it's widely spread, right? For a single title, we are giving many approaches. Okay, for single title, we saw the example that it has four keywords, right? Prevention of disease example had four keywords. So if there is a big title, the keywords will be scattered to large area, and there will be arrangement is also accordingly. There will be sub arrangement for each and entry for each keyword. You have to arrange it in along with the context, right? So sub arrangement is becoming bigger. It will take time to understand how the sequence is processed. Searches often face high recall to low precision. It is ineffective for exhaustive approach for large collection. So when you are having a large collection, this is ineffective. Okay. So these are the various disadvantages of keyword indexing. So coming to the end part, it may offer various advantages, including that of performing well or retrieval of information in computer environment. In fact, it is one of the widely used indexing services in OPAC. That is true. OPAC uses keyword indexing only. Various integrated softwares also, like Libsys, NewGenLib, use this technique for their OPAC. However, one has to keep in mind that machine products can never reach the level of perfection that humans are capable of, and therefore there will always be residual efforts left for humans. That means the machine can only perform whatever instructed to them. So only based on the title they will perform whatever they have programmed. So we only know this title. And the African women example, we saw that the African women, they have given title like this, but they are talking only about the women in Sierra Leone. So like that, the machine doesn't understand those parts, right? Only human can understand that. We have to take care of this residual put this residual efforts, okay, in order to preserve the thought content. It is based on significant words, that is important words, approach terms, and arrangement of this keyword is done alphabetically. So related identical subjects are scattered throughout the index file. So when you are arranged alphabetically, the related subjects or everything comes alphabetically. So it is a long range of index, right? Because no reference system is used for connecting two related terms, right? In PopC process, we saw C also reference, right? Here it is not like that. C also references. Here there is no reference system for connecting. For the Mughal example, we saw that C also Mughals. Okay, there is no reference system to connect possible synonym terms. The users will search for all possibilities to identify the documents. So which takes lots of time. So these are the advantages and disadvantages and the summary of keyword indexing in a nutshell. So kindly go through this particular references which is used to prepare this presentation. So thank you.